Tens of thousands of workers, ranging from costume designers to electricians and video editors, are preparing for a possible strike on Monday that could stop the production of movies and TV shows nationwide. Their union, the International Alliance of Theatrical Stage Employees, is trying to negotiate better working conditions and a larger cut of profits from streaming productions. Joy Press covers television for Vanity Fair, and she's been following the story. Joy Press, welcome to the NewsHour. Thank you for being here. So tell us a little bit more about who these employees are. What kind of work do they do?
Well, the people who are involved in this action are basically the backbone of Hollywood, the invisible workers behind the scenes. So editors, set decorators, grips, you know, cinematographers, just all of the sort of, you know, working people behind the cameras.
And what are they asking for? I know these negotiations have been underway for a while.
Yeah, there are two contracts that sort of ran out months ago, and they are asking for some things that I think a lot of Americans would understand. They're looking for more rest breaks. They're looking for meal breaks. Some of them work, you know, 12 to 18 hours a day, you know, 7 days a week. They're looking for better fees for the lowest paid workers. And they're also, as you said, looking for a better deal in terms of streaming platforms.
And you were telling us, Joy, that a lot of this has come about or been, I should say, exacerbated by what they experienced during the pandemic.
Yeah, I mean, I think that before the pandemic, these workers have traditionally been really tough, right? They have a really can-do attitude, you know, nothing's too hard for us. And I think the pandemic, as a couple of workers said to me, it was really the first time that they'd had a break in, you know, in their working lives, and started to think a little bit about some of the stuff that they put themselves through. And then when they went back to work in this new world of, you know, working 15 hours in, you know, an N95 and not being able to, you know, have lunch at all because you can't take your mask off on set, that kind of thing. And so I think a real sense of grievance started to circulate, and they started kind of discussing, you know, that this really needed to change.
And you were also telling us that this has to do with how the nature of television video watching is changing, that streaming is playing a much bigger role than it used to.
Yeah, I mean, streaming is very different. I think for working people behind the scenes, the work patterns are shorter. You know, network television, you would have many, many episodes. Streaming, you often have a very short burst of work. So you're a gig worker going from job to job. Often they are trying to shoot things faster, particularly now, because during the pandemic, we all ran out of TV. And so, you know, all the production shut down. And so all these studios and streaming platforms are trying to shoot things very, very quickly. So all of that has just exacerbated things. And also in terms of the way that they're paid, they are not getting residuals from syndication and things like that.
The older contract did not reflect this new phenomenon. At this point, are the big production studios, the big media conglomerates, are they inclined to try to make this to give them what they want?
Well, you know, they're in negotiations. I think this has been under discussion for a while. The negotiations have heated up since huge majority of the union, IATSE, the workers union, voted to, you know, that they were willing to go on strike. And they've now set the deadline for this coming Monday. So certainly no one wants a strike. The producers, the studios don't want a strike, and the workers don't want a strike. So, you know, I imagine that they are, you know, pedaling as fast as they can to find something that they can live with.
And if they do end up going on strike, what does it mean for consumers?
It's a huge disruption. I mean, no one that I talk to could soft pedal it. This is 60,000 workers from this union, and they are behind the vast majority of TV shows and movies, they'll shut down. And, you know, other unions are very much in sympathy with them, Hollywood's other unions. And they all have contract negotiations coming up. You know, the actors union, the, you know, SAG, the Directors Guild, the Writers Guild. So, you know, I think it would be, we'd be missing some of our favorite shows for quite a while.
Potentially big impact. Joy Press, for sure. Joy Press with Vanity Fair. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.